female hairline lowering, filling, and rounding out options. Good day, doctors. I am a 22-year-old female, and I was born with a high hairline and an odd cowlick, which exacerbates said condition. The highest dimension from the top of my eyebrow to the highest point in my forehead is exactly 3 inches. I would like, at the very least, an entire inch of hairline advancement. I'm not sure of undergoing surgery for this. Reverse forehead lift, whereby the hairline is lowered through tissue expander placement, or what is currently more appealing to me, hair grafting.
Thank you for your question. At the age of 22, you have done a very good, thorough job with research about your options regarding a naturally high hairline. And your options you're asking about include a tissue expander, reverse forehead lift versus hair grafting, as well as you expressed a concern about the cowlick and the direction of the hair. So I'm in a unique position because I am board certified in facial cosmetic surgery, so I do perform forehead lifts, facelifts, etc., and I'm a specialist in hair restoration. So I basically have all the options in front of me when I see patients like yourself. Here's how I make some of these decisions. I look at skin elasticity, and I look at the risks of relative scarring that can occur from a procedure like a reverse forehead lift. Now, in your situation, I think that you have to take into account that any procedure you consider still has a large lag when you talk about a more surgical type of procedure like a reverse forehead lift versus a hair transplantation procedure. So I would say practically speaking, financially speaking, it might be more practical to consider hair grafting. And so let's discuss hair grafting, which is probably what I would recommend if you were to be seen in our office for consultation. What your goal is to create a lower hairline. But in creating a lower hairline, you have to be mindful of how close the hairs are placed in order to look natural. Many people come to our practice, and the first thing they'll say is, listen, my hairline is up here, and this applies to both men and women. I want my hair down to here. Well, you could start doing a lower hairline at that level, but you won't get the same level of density that would look natural. And so you may have a lower hairline, but the hairs will be too far apart, and you'll need several procedures to get to your desired goal. So one strategy to consider is to slowly lower the hairline from the point where it is most dense and transition from there downward. Now, that would be based on the number of grafts that are available as well as the thickness and quality of the hair. So that's one thing to consider. The other thing to be aware of is, in terms of the cowlick, a procedure that might be helpful in the strategy is to actually take hairs from the cowlick and transplant them in a way so that the direction of the hairs is more advantageous to get better coverage. So this is a kind of a complex concept, but that I think will be helpful when you're ready to go ahead and do the transplantation procedure. Something to also be made aware of that I think that you're not going to come across unless you do your research really aggressively is something we've been doing in our practice and that I've been able to advance over the past 2 to 3 years. And that is the use of something called extracellular matrix. In traditional hair transplantation, a certain percentage of hairs are lost, regardless of how well the transplant is done. the factors such as the hairs being outside of the body for a particular amount of time, the surgical technique employed, the amount of bleeding that occurs, all of those being equal, there is always a certain percentage of hairs that don't make it. Well, what we've been able to successfully do is use this material in a specific way that allows our hair transplant patients to do a little bit better than patients who we've had in our practice who didn't receive this type of care prior to this new technique. Essentially, extracellular matrix heals by duplication of tissue that is, quote, injured. And so this results in the activation of adult stem cells, which we have observed with hair counts actually seems to yield more hairs than are actually transplanted. And this we've been able to document. In addition, if someone has any hair thinning, then that thinning hair, based on genetic patterns such as male or female pattern hair loss, reverses and the hairs thicken. This is based on the concept that the progenitor cells, which become less capable or become defective, if you will, at a certain point that causes hair to thin, actually become restored and protect. So think of progenitor, then protect the hair follicles so that they're able to thrive. So to summarize my recommendation, I would recommend transplant over surgical forehead surgery, as well as the redirecting of hair follicles from the cowlick, basically extracting maybe follicular units and then changing the direction, and considering the use of the extracellular matrix technology that we have been in the forefront of over the past few years with hair transplant surgery. So there's a lot more for you to also consider, and I hope this was educational for you. Thank you for your question.